properties of the indifference curve. Indifference curve slopes downwards from left to right. Indifference curve is convex towards the origin. No two indifference curves cut or touch each other. Well, these are the three important properties of the indifference curve. Let us now examine the first property. Indifference curve slopes downwards from left to right. Indifference curve has a negative slope. As the consumer slides down from left to right, he gives up a few units of good Y in order to acquire one additional unit of good X. When the consumer moves down from point A to B, he parts with 4 units of good Y. Against this, he gets 1 unit of good X. Giving away good Y means loss of utility. Getting 1 unit of good X means gain in utility. Gain balances the loss. Hence, the consumer's total utility remains unaffected. This process must go on along the curve if at all the consumer is to remain at the same level of satisfaction or utility. Indifference curve cannot take any other shape. Look at the top right corner. Here, the indifference curve is assumed to be a vertical curve. It means when the stock of good Y increases from 8 units to 12 units, the stock of good X remains unchanged at 6 units. Of the two combinations S and T, consumer will prefer T. T will offer more utility than S. As S and T represent two different levels of satisfaction, IC cannot have a vertical shape. Again, IC cannot be a horizontal curve. Here, quantity of good Y remains unchanged at 8 units. When the consumer moves from combination C to D, stock of good X alone increases from 6 units to 12 units. Since combination D consists more quantity of good X, consumer will prefer D over C because D gives him more utility than C. For this reason, indifference curve can never be horizontal. Now we shall see what happens if indifference curve is an upward sloping curve. When the consumer moves up from C to combination D, stocks of both the goods are increasing. In this case, D contains more of both X and Y. No doubt, it offers more utility than C. Consumer's choice is D. He cannot be indifferent between C and D. So, indifference curve cannot be an upward sloping curve. A downward sloping curve alone can represent the tendency of fall in the quantity of good Y and rise in the quantity of good X. Indifference curve is convex towards the origin. This is because marginal rate of substitution of x for y is diminishing. The first property says the fall in the stock of good y and the rise in the stock of good x make the indifference curve to slope downwards. This is not enough to prove the unchanging nature of total utility. We need more evidence to support this. It is here the marginal rate of substitution of x for y comes to our rescue. Numerically, we had discussed it under the head slope of the indifference curve. We shall make a simple graphical approach to establish this. We know how to measure the slope of a non-linear curve like indifference curve. We have to draw a tangent. Let us do that here. Take point F on the curve. Draw a tangent to that point. It cuts the y-axis at 10 units and the x-axis at 2 units. Delta y by delta x gives you the slope. 10 by 2 is equal to 5. At point 5, marginal rate of substitution of x for y is 5. Our slope is equal to 5. Similarly, fix the point G. It is to the left of point F. Draw a tangent to that point. It cuts the y-axis at 8 units and the x-axis at 4 units. Marginal rate of substitution of x for y at the point G is 8 by 4, that is 2. So, marginal rate of substitution of x for y is diminishing from 5 to 2 when the consumer descends from F to G. As the stock of good y falls with every exchange, the consumer's concern for good y goes up. That is why marginal rate of substitution of x for y is diminishing and the curve is convex towards the origin. No two indifference curves cut or touch each other. Look at this indifference curve map. It contains two indifference curves. IC1, IC2. Indifference curve 2 cuts indifference curve 1 at point A. Combination A is common to both indifference curves. Upper segment of indifference curve 2 is below IC1. And its lower segment is above IC1. Take two more combinations, C and D. C and B contains the same quantity of good X, 9 units. But quantity of good Y is large in C than in B. Hence, C must offer a higher level of satisfaction than B. It means indifference curve 2 represents a higher level of satisfaction and indifference curve 1 represents a lower level of satisfaction. But A is common to both IC1 and IC2. Then it is absurd to say A will give two different levels of satisfaction simultaneously. It's impossible. Even if we accept in principle that the two can cut, then we have to accept IC2 offering three different levels of utility. Its upper segment gives less utility than IC1. Exactly at point A, its utility equals the utility of IC1. Its lower segment's utility is higher than that of IC1. This idea cuts the very root of the indifference curve analysis. So, for the above said reasons, indifference curves will never cut or touch each other. Thanks for watching.